fresh and new and clean. Right? Well, that's a nice little reminder for us, I think, of what God does for us. Because when Jesus breaks into our world, and when he died on the cross for us, you know what he did for us? He made us fresh and new and clean. Because by his death, he gave us the gift of forgiveness so that everything with us also becomes new. And that just doesn't happen when the winter starts. It happens every single day when God offers us the gift of his forgiveness. And so every day for us is a fresh start. And I think that's a really beautiful day. Okay? Thank you. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. I got to spend a fair amount of time alone with my parents this last week. Now, they're going to be watching this later on, so it was a very pleasant experience. But it seems like more and more, and I don't know if it's something that I would attribute to their age or mine, we do a lot of talking about things that used to be. And I find that when I go home, when I drive back to Woodstock, which doesn't happen very often, that things are just different. First job I ever had, as you know, was carrying the newspaper for an outfit called the Woodstock Daily Sentinel. The Sentinel in Woodstock is a statue that's in the middle of the town square, yes, very quaint town square, of a Civil War soldier standing at attention with his rifle next to him. And I think the reason that they picked that name, beside the fact that it was good marketing, was because the object of the game for the paper was to stand as a sentinel and to tell everyone in town what was going on. Here's the thing, though. Although the sentinel in the middle of the town square still stands, the newspaper fell probably 30 years ago. And I can remember distinctly walking to the back of the Sentinel building to pick up the 47 newspapers that I was to deliver on a daily basis. So here's one of the things we talked about this week. My dad said, "Do you remember where the Sentinel building was?" I said, "What do you mean, was?" He said, "Well, they're going to tear it down. And they're going to put up some apartments." I thought that building would sit there forever. And it's not just the Sentinel building that's changed or gone since I lived there. My parents also spent a great deal of time talking about the house that they now live in, which of course is not the house that I grew up in. So I like to joke with my parents, kind of, that I can go home, but I can't go home because they sold it. Well, it appears that that place is going to be on the market again. I asked my parents if they were going to buy it so that I could go home. My father was somewhat hesitant about the idea. But there and other places, what I think that I discover as I get older, or well, maybe not discover, but rediscover, over and over and over again, that a lot of those things or places that I thought were a mark of stability aren't. Things are ever changing. One of the things that Europeans don't understand about us is how we so quickly and easily tear old buildings down. Because it's not uncommon there to walk into a building that's 800 years old. But even there, we observed just a short time ago, Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris burning from the inside out. That mark of permanence, gutted by fire. What we discover then is even those things that we think are forever aren't. We can't. We mustn't justify our existence by anything that isn't permanent. And on this side of the sod, there's very little that is. Now, this is not a new human experience, because if we look at the gospel lesson for this morning, Jesus exited the temple, it says. And that's not just any temple. It's the Temple of Solomon, the most important location in the world for people in Jesus' time. And they thought, they knew that that building was permanent. Why? Because in it was a place called the Holy of Holies, where it was said that God lived. Here's something I don't think they remember. The temple had been destroyed once before and rebuilt. But Jesus says, not even this building, not even this place, the place where it is said that God dwells, is permanent. Not one stone will be left upon another. And so, they asked him, as I think I probably would too, when? When is this going to happen? And what does Jesus say? Watch. Well, it did happen. It happened in 70 AD when the temple was torn down and literally one stone was not left upon another. So much so, the destruction of the temple was so complete that we cannot say with any real precision exactly where the foundations of the temple were. Imagine, just for a moment, how destructive that was to the faith of the people who placed their faith in what was said to be in that building. It's not just buildings. We live in a time of great upheaval. We live in a time where people question our institutions, where people question our motives, where people question just about everything. Because it doesn't feel like, for a lot of us, that there's very sure ground anywhere around us. And I think it's true, excepting one thing. Whenever our faith is placed anywhere that isn't in Christ Jesus, we will be disappointed. Because those things, frankly, just don't last. It's a first commandment issue. The first commandment is, simply, you shall have no other gods. And precisely, that means that you shouldn't put your faith anywhere that isn't in God first. For us, that is primary. And why is it primary? Quite simply, is because faith in God, in Christ Jesus, is the only thing that's sure. And the only thing that lasts. So for us, the day or the hour doesn't matter, but what matters is that our Lord Jesus is faithful and true through all times and in all places. and the sacrifice once and for all of Jesus on the cross is our sure and only foundation. For the disciples, for us, Jesus is the only thing that lasts. And because of his grace and love for us and his death upon the cross, we too have been made eternal. Because of the grace of Almighty God, we who also are temporary have been given the promise of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. Because of God's faithfulness and God's permanence, we have been made permanent. That's a gift. And it's a gift that we can share. Paul says faith comes by hearing, through proclamation, through sharing, by the gift of the Holy Spirit. And if we know where our trust lies, then it's essential for us that we share that good news with all the world. But knowing again and again and again that we are called to turn or return to the foot of the cross and to see there the incredible permanence of God's love, God's care, God's concern, and God's activity in our temporary lives. About a half a mile, tops, from where the Sentinel building was, I guess, stands another building that was pretty important to me when I was growing up. That building housed Grace Lutheran Church, a congregation of my youth. We sold that building and moved in about 1985, so before I was out of high school, before some of you were born. The building still stands, but it's a wreck of a place. It looks terrible. And when I talked to my mother about that, you know what she said? She said, when we moved from there to the new church, we probably should have torn the old church down. And as sacred a space as that was and is to me, I think she's probably right. Because when the congregation left that building, it ceased to be the church. But even more so for you and for me, when we leave this building, we take the church with us. Christ accompanies us outside of this door. And in about, I don't know, an hour and a half or so, at least for a little while, this will cease to be the church, because the church will be out there in the world, reminding us and the world around us that the only permanence that there is the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Well, without it. Amen. The hymn of the day is number 627 in the blue book, My Lord, My Lord.
Thank you.
the Green Book with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Gracious Lord God, we give you thanks because you are our refuge and our strength. You are the permanence in a world where everything else is temporary. Lord, in your mercy. We also give you thanks, dear Lord, that you, as the scripture says, have fit us to be living stones for that house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Keep us mindful that we were created for eternity, and by the gift of Christ's death and resurrection, we have been made your people and have been given a home, eternal in the heavens with you. Lord, in your mercy. Dear Lord, we ask also that as we live in this world, that you would bless and care for us and all of creation, that you would keep us mindful that we are called each day to live in your world and to tend to one another. Lord, in your mercy. And we give you thanks that you have assembled us here as your church. But we also ask that you keep us mindful that your church exists where people are assembled, and that as we leave this place, this day or any day, that we take your presence out into the world with us. Lord, in your mercy. We also ask this day that you would provide the gift of healing and a reminder of your salvation to us and to all who are ill. That you each day would touch each and all who suffer with your healing hand, especially those we name now before you in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
The night which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins. those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.